Welcome back to another Mermaid Monday, where we talk about everything mermaid. So today I thought I would go through and show you and tell you a little bit about like mermaid hair. So I haven't really done a video on mermaid hair yet, and it was requested about my hair routine not long ago, so I thought I would just combine the two and give you mermaid hair video. So today with the mermaid hair, I have a few different of my accessories here that I'm gonna show you, and I'm gonna talk a little bit about making your own hair accessories and kind of like hair care type of thing. So first I'm gonna start off with like the accessories for your hair. I have a few different ones. This is one of the first ones that I've made. I took like one of these types of clips that like stick into your hair and added a few different things to it, like a little starfish, some shells that I collected on the beach. You can get seashells from like the craft store as well, or you can order them online, have them shipped out to you. So it's really neat. This one's good for like if you have your hair pulled back and you just wanna look a little mermaidy and stick it in the back. Like, I don't know if you can see that or not, but like that. I'm gonna assume you can see that. So this one was one of the first ones I made. I never really wear this one though, because I never pull my hair back when I go out. Usually my hair is down. I put it like in braids a lot, so I don't get a chance to wear this one. But if you pull your hair back and you just wanna add a little extra mermaidy, this one's great. I never wear it for, like, I never find a use for it for like events. Like when I first got into mermaiding, I made all the stuff that I could have, and then I was just like, oh, what if we did this, what if we did this, and I didn't really use most of it. One thing that I did use a lot, which actually just recently broke, I have to re-glue this one here, like, not re-glue, but I need to glue this back on because it broke off, so is this sea star. I got this at the craft store and then hot glued it to a little clip here. It's like an alligator clip, so it'll hold well in your hair. I use this a lot for like the Little Mermaid. Whenever I'm like in mermaid costume, I feel like I need a little extra in my hair, I'll clip that in. It looks really cute and it's great. You can just clip it anywhere you want. So I do recommend getting these. If you want to make it yourself, you can. If not, some people make them and sell them like on Etsy and stuff. So it's really cool, really neat. It just adds a little extra mermaid to your look. This one I got, a girl on Instagram actually made it for me. She did really super great. Like, she painted the shell and then put the pearls on it, which is great because I love pearls, and then put the clips. So for this one, I feel like you would like clip it kind of wherever you need to into your hair, and it just kind of sits there. I haven't really found a use to wear it yet, because it's just kind of large, and I can never get it right in my hair. So it's kind of difficult, and it's kind of stuck in my hair right now. There we go. I had to unclip some. Some of my hair got caught. Sometimes it does that. These are basic little clips here, so you can see that. So that's that. So this one's really cute. So you can make these at home. You can find places online. Those are just like the simple little things just to kind of add a little extra. This one, we got a, basically, this one's not much of a mermaid one as much as I use it just for myself. It's just a little black crown. It kind of blends in with my hair, so I don't really wear it too often. But with this one, we took like a princess crown and then we spray painted it black, and then we added the jewels into here, here, and here. And so it made it super cute. So that's that one. You can do that with yourself. You can take a crown and then just glue on seashells and different things like that. I've seen that. I have one. I just couldn't find it at the moment. So whenever I do find it, I'll show you guys in another video later on. But I'll see if I'll find a picture. I'll put a picture here of the one that I made. But yeah, you just use this as a base and then put stuff around it, and then we had to kind of add like extra. I would add like a little thing right here to wrap around your head to keep it in place, because they do get heavy whenever you add extra stuff onto them, which is why I like flower crowns a lot. This flower crown is needs a little touch up. It's been like smushed down in a bag, that I have for all my mermaid stuff, but it still works great. So this is the one. Like I said, it does need a touch up. I wear this one. I've worn this one before in videos. You just wear it on your head. You just slide it. And bam, flower crown. It's super cute and super pretty, and it's really light, which I love. So you can wear it for a longer period. So if you have like a birthday party that's like an hour, you can wear this one or like a book reading or something, and it won't hurt your head. So that's that one. It also has cute little pearl things sticking up. Some of them fell out. There was more over here, but over time, I've had this for like a year. Over time, it kind of just came undone. So we have to do a little touch-ups to this one. But altogether, this one is like one of my favorite ones to wear. It's just really cute. And basically, you just take a headband, and then you kind of glue on flowers and stuff to it, and then it just turns out great. Some people take like a, I want to say velvet, but I'm not sure if that's the right term for it, but like felt, something like that, something like that, put it on the bottom and the top, and you can add more stuff onto it too. So that is the flower one. Another headband one that I made with mom's help is this one. This one is on a headband. She did take stuff that I was talking about right here, added it in to get make it more stable, and like put it foam on the back. And then what we did is we put some seashells, some sea stars, and other little accessories and stuff, and just glued those on and glued it around the back, so that way it's super cute. So with this one, you just slide that onto your head. This one is heavy, so you kind of have to balance. You can't really look down or else it falls, so you kind of have to be a little careful, but it's not, it looks really good for like especially photos and stuff like that. Get down a little bit more, so it's like really cute and big. It's like a giant crown, so it's pretty. So there's that one. All of these are pretty easy to make if you're crafty. If you're not crafty, there are like Etsy shops that make mermaid crowns and like do it yourselves on YouTube on how to. I'll have to try and make one. A do-it-yourself and show you how to make a mermaid crown later on. But right now I'm just showing you all of mine and showing you what you can do if you are already crafty. So this one was made by Bridget, also called Treasure Coast Mermaid. This one has a seashell and has some extra stuff coming off and some little pretty stuff, and then has the netting on top. So with this one, you take it and you throw it over your head like that. And it just gives it like an extra like mermaid-y look. I like to wear this one whenever I'm doing like meet and greets and stuff like that. It does look cute for photos too. It looks really good. I like how the green kind of goes in with the hair too. Especially if you have like longer hair, it would look really good too. But I don't have long hair, that long of hair. So it just looks pretty good for me. I enjoy it. I do wear it kind of often, not too often, but kind of. I don't like to wear it for like birthday parties and stuff like that, because when you're interacting with the kids, you'll bend down to pick stuff and you'll look down and stuff. So the heavier ones, they don't do too great unless you're doing like a performance where you're sitting up straight, or else that one would also slide off of your head too. So one thing that people don't normally think about when they think about hair accessories is like hats. You can wear a hat and be a mermaid. I have myself here a pirate hat. I got it at a pirate festival. It is a little bit big on my head, but normally, I can't find it right now, but normally I would have a bandana, and that usually fills a spot. So I would tie a bandana around my head, you know, like a pirate bandana, and then set this right on top, and it works great, and it looks cute because it has little bows, and it's black, and it has red, so it matches my tail. And it's just a cute little accessory to go with it. So I like it. I think it looks cute. Here's a picture of me wearing it at an event. So that's this one. It has 3 points. You can get different types of hats. You can try them on. Usually they do look really cute, and they do help with the sun. If you're outside doing a meet and greet or something, it really helps the sun like stay out of your face. So I do have like other crowns and stuff, but I'm not gonna go into detail because I couldn't find all of my crowns right now and all of my stuff. But I think I will go ahead and move on to like hair care. So when it comes to hair care, a lot of times everybody has different types of hair for one. One thing that gets me, like, it's a minor annoyance is when people try to tell me how to deal with the oil in my hair, because I have really oily hair. I've tried everything. There's nothing that you can tell me that I haven't tried. Like, seriously, like, it's so bad. People always try to tell me, like, oh, this is what you do to get rid of the oil. Oh, I can only wash your hair, like, once a week. And all of this other kind of stuff. Or use this certain type of shampoo. Like, no. I've dealt with my hair my entire life. If I use too much conditioner, my hair gets oily. If I use too little conditioner, my hair gets oily. If I don't use shampoo, my hair gets oily. If I use too much shampoo, my hair gets oily. Like, there has to be a balance when it comes to my specific hair. My hair, I can't go 24 hours without washing it. Mine is getting oily now because I haven't showered yet today. But my hair gets oily within 24 hours. So I have to wash my hair constantly. I'm sure this will change if I'm, like, let's say I'm going in the ocean a lot more. I would need to probably condition more and, you know, it would dry it out. So if you're, like, around the ocean a lot or you're doing things where your hair gets dried out a lot, then, yeah, you need to, you know, condition your hair, decondition your hair. Some people, their hair starts getting damaged and breaks easy. I don't really know exactly how to help you there because I have really oily hair. My hair is too oily sometimes. So, I know that, like, when it comes to chlorine and salt water, you do need to take good care of your hair. So I would, like, recommend talking to, like, a cosmetology student or, like, a hair specialist or something and have their thoughts and opinions, or look it up online and just kind of see what would be best for you, because me telling you what I do with my hair is gonna be different for you unless you have the same type of hair, which is curly and oily. So I have very curly and oily hair, so it's not gonna work out very well. My hair is kind of like wavy now because I've been like brushing it down all day. But it is pretty curly. I'm trying to go for like the Moana look. Eventually, when my hair gets longer, I'll be there. But not yet. I'm still waiting. So now my bangs are like being really weird and like they're just really odd. Like I don't know what they're doing. Like they're weird. They're like curling weirdly. Like they're curling differently than everything else in my hair. So my hair is just really different. And that's one thing I have to stress is what works for my hair is not going to work for you. So with my hair, how do I get it curly? It gets wet and it just curls naturally. I do because I live in Florida and it's humid all the time. I have to use something to keep the frizz down. So this is what I use to keep the frizz down. I don't know what it's called. You can use like a lot of things like curling gel, sprays, hairspray, different things like that to try and keep the frizz down. My hair does get like really frizzy in Florida. So I do just add that extra in there. If you have like straight hair, you're not gonna get super, super curly hair unless you like actually curl it. You can try and use curlers. I know some people do that and they just sleep in it overnight. Some people just add coconut oil and kind of make it matty and kind of try and get it to have a mermaidy look. That's pretty much all I have for like hair care wise, but just make sure like do what's best for your hair. Don't listen to people who have like not your type of hair. If you have like super straight hair, then what somebody with super curly hair says isn't gonna really work for you unless they know, like, they're like a hair specialist. So I would recommend going to a hair specialist to find out what's best for your hair health and for your hair growth and all this and that. For me personally, I just use whatever shampoo I can find on the aisle. Some shampoos and conditioners don't work, like, in Ulta, there's a Not Your Mother's stuff. That stuff makes my hair extremely oily, like, I can use like no shampoo and just a little bit of conditioner, super oily. I could use only shampoo, super oily. I can't use that stuff because it makes my hair so oily so quick. So for me, I just usually use whatever I can find. I usually use like Pantene or something like that. And I would just put a little bit of shampoo, like this much shampoo and rub it in, lather it up, and then rinse it out. And then if my hair is still super oily, I'll do it again and just put a little bit more. And usually that does the trick. Usually I only have to use like one. I rarely have to use like two washes of shampoo. And then when it comes to conditioner, I just put like a little bit here, like just like a dime or like a penny or something. Sometimes a quarter, depending on how dry my hair is or how oily my hair is. But for the most part, I just put like a dime and then put it in the ends of my hair first and then work it up. And then I would just put like a little bit up here for my bangs and stuff. But for the most part, just the ends. If I get it too much on my scalp, I'll have super oily hair. So I have that problem. So if you have that problem, let me know in the comments so I can relate. But I don't know how to help you have dry hair or like super straight hair. Because I'm only used to doing what works best for me. For people with like shorter hair, like let's say you have like a medium length cut, you have a few options to make your hair longer. You can wear extensions or wear a wig. You know, either of those options work great for you. You don't have to. You never really have to wear extensions or a wig. It's not mandatory at all. There's no rules about being a mermaid. There's plenty of mermaids with short hair too. And honestly, I think short hair would be more functional for swimming for real mermaids. To me, I'd say so. So for me, my hair has grown out a lot since I got my extensions, but my hair used to be about here, so I do have these extensions that I would wear. I have them black extensions so that way they match my hair. I've had these since like high school, so like years. These are really old. They're almost about to be retired because my hair is almost as long as these are whenever my hair is in. Like whenever my extensions are in. See, they're almost there. So I haven't been wearing my extensions lately, but for the first like year or so, year and a half of being a mermaid, I would wear hair extensions. Especially because I do have this shaved side right here. So I have like a whole chunk missing, so I'll just add some up here to make it even. So with these, I have to like keep up with them. This is real human hair, so they can be straightened, they can be curled, all that stuff. These are usually more expensive than the synthetic ones. The synthetic ones, though, a lot of times they're either really low setting for like heat resistance, or they're not heat resistant at all. Those are fine. You can get those, especially if you're just swimming with them, then it doesn't really matter too much. You can braid them into your hair. You can get like a few of those little extensions and just clip them in, give your hair an extra color, switch it up a bit. I have seen people do that. Some people braid it in with their hair and make it look like they have multicolors in their hair. And some people who hair, they dye it like blue or purple or something. Sometimes they'll have shorter hair because dyeing does kind of kill your hair. Not like extremely bad if you keep up with it and you do it correctly. Like, don't use box dyes. I highly recommend not using box dyes if you're gonna bleach your hair. I use box dye only whenever I dye it like a darker color, because I have naturally like brown. Like, I don't know if you can tell my roots right now, but it's brown and then it fades out into black because I dye my hair black. So like, it's really hard to notice. I don't know if you guys can see it or not, but normally it's like brown and then it gets black here, kind of. But it like blends together, so I don't really worry too much about it. But that's the only times I use box dye. I do not recommend box dye. if you dye your hair, I would recommend going to like a hairstylist or something, because they have the good quality products that's not going to kill your hair, and they know a little bit more about what they're doing. If you want to use box dye and you've used box dyes, then that's great. I'm glad that your hair is healthy. But for people who don't already dye their hair with box dyes, I recommend going to somebody else. I don't trust myself to bleach my hair, so I would kill my own hair if I did that. So for extensions, you can get clip-ins, which is what I have. They just clip on in. You can get tape-ins. You can get sew-ins. There's a bunch of options for you to do if you want the longer hair. The sew-ins, and the glue-ins usually last a little bit longer than the clip-ins. The clip-ins you can take in and out, but the sew-ins and the glue-ins, usually those last a little bit longer. I think the tape-ins and the glue-ins can come out if you, like, want them to. But the sew-ins, you actually have to go and get them done, and they stay in for a long period of time. I've never gotten sewn-ins, but I've known some people who have, and they look natural. They look great. The other option for you is wigs. Wigs galore. I bought a few wigs from Wig is Fashion, and I know some other mermaids use them. I bought this wig on Amazon. Usually, if you're just planning on swimming with your wig, I would go with the cheaper one from, like, Amazon or something. Just because it's going to get tangled. It's going to get messed up. You know, it's going to have chlorine in it from swimming in the pool. It's going to get salt water if you're in the ocean. You know, it's just, it's going to get dirty and it's going to get knotted. And it's going to be difficult to brush. This thing is so knotted up and matted that it's just so... It's just, I can't brush it out. I've never been able to brush this hair. So what I do with this wig, this is my swimming aerial wig. I have one for dry land and I have this one for swimming. This one I got on like Amazon for like $15-$30. So it's a cheaper one, but it's great. When it comes to swimming with wigs on though, remember it's going to get knotted. It's going to get messed up. So I would go with the cheaper one. That's just me. You can get a more expensive one if you want. You're just gonna have to keep up with it a little bit better. This one is all synthetic. You can tell it's synthetic. It does feel kind of realistic, but it doesn't feel like real hair. But kids don't notice the difference. Sometimes people don't even notice the difference, honestly. So, for this one, whenever I'm swimming with it, what I do is I do it differently than most people do. I'll tell you what I do, and then I'll tell you what most people do. What I do is I braid my hair in like a French braid and then bobby pin it up, and then I throw this on top. I don't wear a wig cap with this one, and I just toss it on, and it's good to go. And then for inside of this wig, most wigs have this. I'm not experienced in wigs. I don't really know too much, but I know that they come with this. I think these are supposed to clip into your hair and connect to the wig cap to make it tighter. But what I do when I'm swimming is this cap is big enough to where I can. I just slide it in here and connect them. And it works at like a headband. So my head is like right here and it works and it keeps it tight. That's really all I do to swim with this wig. And then I'm just careful. I don't like dive straight in. Like I have to dive a little bit. But I don't go under where my wig would come up. You know, I dive head first everywhere I go. And then I do adjust the wig. I'll kind of act like I'm scratching, but I'll just be pulling it down a little bit, you know. And for the most part, nobody's ever noticed. And my wig has only, like, come up, like, once or twice as many times as I use this thing. So it's really good to, you can do that. Now, what other people do is you're supposed to put, like, a wig cap, put all your hair in a wig cap, hold it up. And then some people, especially if you have a lace front wig, you get like, waterproof, like wig glue or wig tape or, even waterproof eyelash glue and put it on here and then put that down. And then people will bobby pin it into their hair so that it'll stay down. And then some of them have clips that clip into your hair too. Some wigs come with that. And then a lot of times they'll also have hair accessories that can go in the water. Like, I know I've seen some that they put it on, it's like a headband or like a headpiece, and it stays on and it keeps their wig on too. So it really helps with that as well. You can look into that. I don't have anything that I really wear in the water, but I have seen it like on Instagram or something. So it's really cool. So you can try those both ways. It works great for me. You've seen me swimming it with this wig. Probably, if not, I'll... at the end of the video, I have a thing pop up so that we can see. So that's this one. I have a few other wigs, but I don't really swim with them or anything. I kind of just wear them to wear them. So there's just different things that you can do when it comes to your hair. So if you have any questions that I didn't cover or want to go over again or go into more detail about or show you examples of, let me know in the comments. Feel free to like this video if you enjoyed it and want more content. And I'll see you guys next week. So feel free to click any of the videos that pop up. And I'll see you guys next week. So mermaid kisses and starfish wishes.